Hi, my name is Adina Menzel from the cast of Rent, and a lot of us have left and moved on to do other things, and if you're interested, you should tune in to Showbiz Today, because we're moving on. See ya.
Hi, everyone. I'm Jim Moray in Hollywood.
And I'm Lauren Sidney in New York, and in a moment, the anniversary of a shocking event, how the death of one superstar rocked Hollywood. But first, today's Showbuzz. For Whitney, charity begins in Washington, D.C. She's in the Capitol rehearsing for her live HBO concert on Sunday, which benefits the Children's Defense Fund. Defending kids is a cause that she is committed to.
They don't have big voices, you know. They've got these little ones screaming out somewhere, saying, help me. And not one child is going to be left behind.
Some gay critics are bent out of shape over the movie Bent. They're accusing the Motion Picture Association of America of a double standard for slapping the movie about Nazi persecution of gays with an NC-17 rating. The Gay and Lesbian Alliance Against Defamation says the movie only got the restrictive rating because it depicts gay sex, not heterosexual acts. 12 years ago to the day, Rock Hudson lost his battle with AIDS. The shocking revelation of his illness dramatically increased public awareness of the disease. Gloria Hillard recalls the event that changed America and Hollywood alike.
AIDS had been among us then, but it wasn't until this day, in 1985, when Rock Hudson appeared in public with longtime friend Doris Day, that something changed.
He came into the press conference in front of a vast number of journalists, and they all gasped. There was an audible gasp.
On a disease called AIDS, there was now a face.
He was a movie star. He had everything in the whole world going for him, money, fame, looks. You know, he had everything, but he was going to die. This could happen to your son, your brother. Hey, America, wake up.
Wake up call for Hollywood was the loudest. A number of people behind the scenes had already died when another famous face announced,
we will not be defeated by this illness.
And Elizabeth Taylor's American Foundation for AIDS Research, AMFAR, was born. AIDS fundraising had begun, and the symbol for consciousness raising was a red ribbon. Red ribbons and hand-sewn quilts.
Steve Dunn. Lee Emmerich.
And names, hundreds of names.
Michael Struck.
Ronald E. Gaskin. And my dearest brother, Michael Haggerty.
I have more people that I've known and worked with and loved, you know, die.
And each year we did stories. Every 10 minutes someone dies from AIDS. At some museums, every 10 minutes the bell tolled for them. And each year added names to the increasing list of those who had died.
Felt like stone, I heard. Voices of friends vanished and gone. At night I could hear the blood in my veins.
The story of AIDS was brought to the stage. And the screen. Yes. In 1992, Middle America watched Tom Hanks in an Oscar-winning portrayal of a gay man dying of AIDS. And today, Hollywood continues to tell stories like Gloria Rubin's character's battle with HIV on ER.
Okay, I just don't want my personal life spread all over the hospital.
This is AIDS Project Los Angeles, founded in 1982 and funded largely by Hollywood. Today, the AIDS service-based organization is busier than ever.
We see here at AIDS Project Los Angeles 5 to 7 new people every day.
Hollywood stars led the annual APLA AIDS Walk in late September. The fundraisers go on.
I think the Hollywood community is the most supportive of the entire nation.
And earlier this month, 12 years after she first came forward to talk about AIDS.
I'm sorry that once again, we must all be here.
AIDS may not be in the headlines like yesterday, but just the other day, the line at the APLA food bank was 3 hours long. Gloria Hillard, CNN Entertainment News, Los Angeles.
Mother Teresa spent her life comforting the afflicted, and now her remarkable story is coming to television in a Family Channel movie airing this weekend. Sherry Sylvester reports on this spiritual undertaking.
Action, Jody.
And
What began as a chronicle of the life of Mother Teresa became a tribute in her memory. The Hallmark Entertainment film Mother Teresa in the Name of God's Poor was made long before her death.
I work here in Motegi.
In this slum? With these hooligans?
These people are my sisters and my brothers.
She gives people a couple of seconds or a couple of minutes of love when they're dying or when they most need it. And she touches them, and it seems so simple, but it's so moving.
Geraldine Chaplin tackles this monumental role, and if it seems absurd to cast any actress in the part, the notion was not lost on her.
I was so shocked. I burst out laughing. I thought it was a joke. I said, what? Mother Teresa? What? And then I thought, oh, it's incredible. What an incredible part.
It was an incredible life, made more difficult to portray by the fact that Mother Teresa was so well known and so well loved.
I worked a lot in front of a mirror and imitating and watching her videos and imitating and imitating. And then that got so depressing because I just couldn't. I felt every time I saw myself, I felt it was wrong. So then I got rid of the mirrors and did it and tried to really feel like her.
In an interview earlier this summer, Chaplin talked about gaining insight into the inner spirit of the humble woman who was honored with the Nobel Peace Prize.
She talks about going out and cleaning the wounds, the maggot-infested wounds of people who are dying. And she touches every terrible, almost corpse. And she says, it's Jesus Christ that I'm touching.
He shall be judged by what we have done for and to the poor.
It affected me tremendously personally. After this film, there's something which is so important, which is goodness.
Contacted Wednesday, Chaplin told CNN she wishes everyone who sees the film would send $1 to the Missionaries of Charity so they can continue Mother Teresa's work. Sherry Sylvester, CNN, Los Angeles.
The original cast of Rent is vacating Broadway. See where they're headed. And why is the cast of Titanic singing songs of love?
Christina, Christina.
Beyond the horizon and across the sea, there lives a beautiful princess. When evening nears, she dresses in silver and shimmering light and dances with the rising tide until the stars applaud. She'll touch your heart. Princess, let her take you away.
The people who make Zantac would like you to know, if you've been taking prescription-strength Zantac, you may be able to take Zantac 75 to relieve your tough heartburn. As your doctor can tell you, Zantac 75 contains the same medicine as prescription strength Zantac, and Zantac 75 is available over the counter. Ask your doctor if non-prescription strength Zantac 75 is right for you. Zantac 75.
From the dance phenomenon of a decade comes Bill Whelan's Grammy Award-winning album, Riverdance. Riverdance, the album. Of song and dance. Bring home the power of Riverdance the album. Available on Celtic Heartbeat Universal Records. Also available, The Roots of Riverdance, a collection of music from the composer of Riverdance.
Of all the senses, the sense of sight, the sense of hearing, the sense of smell, the sense of taste, the sense of touch. Of all the senses, the most important may be the sense of style. Without the clench, on CNN.
The original final Broadway production of the hit musical Rent rocketed an entire cast of unknowns to stardom. Many of the actors have since left the show, but they have not left the spotlight. Rent has served as a springboard, leading to roles on The X-Files, movies opposite Angela Bassett, and aspiring heavy metal bands. The original cast of the hit Broadway musical Rent should have no trouble making those payments now. Many have moved on to their own record deals, movie roles, and TV shows.
As soon as you get something wonderful like this, you're looking on to the next thing, and that doesn't seem fair. I mean, there are so many people that would die just to be on Broadway.
Idina Menzel was a sex kitten of the show, whose purring on stage caught the eye of a record company, as did her co-star Daphne Rubin Vega. Meow.
Thanks to the show, a lot of opportunities came, so when the right one comes along, you snatch it.
Other departures soon followed.
We're all trying to find a way to deal with this.
Jesse Martin left the show to join TV's 413 Hope Street, and Taye Diggs left to join Angela Bassett in the film based on the hit book, How Stella Got Her Groove Back.
I think it's easier for, you know, the powers that be to pull somebody out of a great show and put them in something else, as opposed to like pulling somebody out of nowhere, you know, who may be just as talented, just as beautiful.
You know, it was the talk of the town, and, you know, we were in the cast, so, you know, we were, you know, at the top of everybody's, you know, headshot piles for that couple of seconds. To being an us
once instead of a them. Anthony Rapp hasn't joined them yet, though he will appear on an upcoming episode of The X-Files. He is one of the few still belting it out on Broadway.
We're all sort of savvy enough to know that it's good for our careers, whatever that means. But at the same time, at the heart of it, In the center of it all was this incredible commitment to what we were doing.
Adam Pascal's commitment to the stage has kept him with Rent 2 while his band awaits a record deal. Meanwhile, his old roommates are no longer able to share in the rent.
I'm not surprised that Taye got the movie, you know. I'm not surprised that Jesse got the TV show. I mean, these are two of the most talented people I've ever met. I never had any doubts in my mind that any of them would get what they wanted.
So to sum it up, thanks to Rent, a bunch of young actors can now afford mortgages. Jim?
So how do you land a part in a hot Broadway play like Rent? Some do it the old-fashioned way, through auditions, and for others, it's just being in the right place at the right time. Bill Tush looks at the way a star is born.
Sing to me. Sing to me.
Getting people to sing for him isn't quite so difficult for casting director Bernard Telsey anymore.
Because of the original show, got so much attention. People know what Rent is, so they come to the open call because they also know it's like a happening. And they also know it's a real chance to get discovered.
Sure, now Rent is the hottest theater ticket in town. But once upon a time,
no one knew who we were, and Rent was nothing in the beginning.
And in New York City, Telsey was charged with scraping together a gritty East Village cast. So he combed clubs, all kinds of clubs.
Well, we did the drag club circuit, because originally, and he still is, Angel was a drag queen. The guy who played Roger, you know, never been on stage before. He was a rock and roller from clubs.
That rock and roller is Adam Pascal.
I did it strictly for the experience of auditioning for something.
And finding the characters was only part of the casting director's job. Next task, getting them to audition.
For Rent, nobody knew what it was about in the beginning. So I was like, I don't want to sing, because they said it was a musical. So I skipped my first audition. I just called in sick.
My thanks to all of you for coming. It was a great...
Higher-profile productions can find gold the old-fashioned way. Paul Simon held a contest 2 years ago searching for untapped talent for The Cape Man, his show coming to Broadway this fall. And last year, Annie producers shopped across America in a highly publicized hunt for the next little red-headed orphan.
Does anyone know how tall Chuck McCready is?
Barry Moss has been casting Broadway shows for nearly two decades.
I'm certainly at showcases three or four times a week. I go to cabarets. Certainly we see every major film that comes out in minor films.
He's seen the shows change, and along with that, the kind of talent.
To today, you have to be able to do it all. If you're going to do a musical on Broadway, you have to be able to sing and dance and act.
And once a show hits the road, it seems a successful cast comes calling.
Sometimes your national company will have somebody even better than the original. You'll discover somebody.
And now do it as if like you just discovered this for the first time.
Now that the show is setting up residents in seven cities, Bernard Telsey is finally seeing Rent get its due. Bill Tush, CNN Entertainment News, New York.
Don McLean serves up a slice of American pie on his 52nd birthday Thursday. The captain of Star Trek Deep Space Nine, Avery Brooks, celebrates 49 years. And every breath Sting takes will be to blow out his 46 candles.
The people who make Zantac would like you to know, if you've been taking prescription-strength Zantac, you may be able to take Zantac 75 to relieve your tough heartburn. As your doctor can tell you, Zantac 75 contains the same medicine as prescription-strength Zantac, and Zantac 75 is available over-the-counter. Ask your doctor if non-prescription-strength Zantac 75 is right for you. Zantac 75.
This fall, the critics agree only one movie has the smarts.
What are we going to do?
They're going to come for us. I mean, you are an important guy, right?
The suspense.
He's toying with us.
And the nerve-wracking adventure.
I'm going to kill the bear.
Say it!
That will take you to the edge.
You make me sick.
I'm sure I do.
Anthony Hopkins.
You want to die out here.
Alec Baldwin.
I don't want to hear!
The Edge. It's the year's best movie. Rated R. Now playing only in theaters.
Florida's natural, not from concentrate premium juice is made by a co-op of growers who are, well, like most traditional families. For example, they never miss their yearly gathering. They always respect their elders, and they constantly look out for the next generation. Sure, the folks who make Florida's natural see things a little differently. After all, they own the land, they own the trees, they own the company. Taste the difference it makes. Florida's natural premium juice.
This Friday, stay up late for the second annual All-You-Can-Eat All-Nighter and watch Dick Tracy, Hudson Hawk, Streets of Fire, and The Fly. Dinner and a movie, All-You-Can-Eat All-Nighter. Beginning 8:05 Eastern Friday, All-You-Can-Eat All Night Long on the Superstation.
This is Sherry Sylvester with the Hollywood Minute. Casting news, Alec Baldwin is set to star in Outside Providence. He'll play the blue-collar father of a teenager. James Woods is expected to say yes to Another Day in Paradise, a dark story set in the 70s. Bob Newhart and Judd Hirsch are calling on their former co-stars for comedy. The two will be joined in their new series, George and Leo, by actors who worked on The Bob Newhart Show, Newhart and Taxi. They have dubbed the November 3rd episode, The Cameo Show. Home Improvement is being honored for dealing with matters outside the home, namely the environment. The comedy series gets the Environmental Media Association's highest honor in ceremonies next month. This is Sherry Sylvester with the Hollywood Minute.
The stars of Star Trek invite you on an outer space adventure. Cast members from the original series are taking part in a new interactive game for aspiring space cadets. Dennis Michael plays along with that and more in the Tech Guide.
All you can say is wow when it comes to Final Fantasy VII. The long-running game series' latest version recently arrived in the Sony PlayStation platform and sold 300,000 copies in its first day. In Japan, they sold over 2.5 million copies already. So it's not only wow in sales, but wow in appearance. Complex adventure game has some of the best-looking game graphics ever. It's back to school time, but the school here is in the Star Trek universe. Interplay has released Starfleet Academy for those who wish to boldly go, well, you know.
Now entering Onyx System, Captain.
Cadets can try their own approach to the infamous Kobayashi Maru scenario or numerous other tests for would-be Starfleet captains, and there are familiar faces on the faculty. George Takei and Walter Koenig of the original Star Trek spent some time before the green screens with this game's cast.
Oh, man, you weren't kidding about this place. Well, I just love it.
Do I know you?
There's nowhere near as much story on virtual Springfield. Fox Interactive's title simply allows you to wander around where only Bart Simpson has gone before. Cowabunga, dude. I'm Dennis Michael with the Tech Guide.
Hey, Jack!
Okay.
Christina!
When we return, the cast of Titanic is donating more than just their voices. And tomorrow, Winona performs live.
When love starts talking, you got no choice but to shut up and listen. It's a powerful voice. Open the door.
20 white children came out of that fire,
and one Negro boy didn't even make it downstairs.
Why?
Don't miss Hope, a film by Goldie Hawn. Sunday, October 19th at 8, exclusively on TNT.
She was the Queen of England. He was a common man with an invitation to the palace. Their unlikely friendship.
She was drunk, I tell you.
Transformed the world's greatest empire. Roger Ebert raves Mrs. Brown is an early candidate for big-time Academy Award nominations. ABC's Joel Siegel calls it one of the year's best films.
Without you, I cannot find the strength to be who I must be.
Her Majesty, Mrs. Brown. Rated PG. Now playing.
There's a place where the stars shine night and day, and the greatest movies of all time play uninterrupted and commercial-free from that big film reel in the sky. Some folks call it a channel, but Turner Classic Movies is, well, it's movie heaven. For your own piece of movie heaven, call your cable company and ask for Turner Classic Movies. Truly movie heaven.
Sunday. An old drug is making a deadly comeback in the American Midwest.
Methamphetamine is unlike any other drug that's out there. It can kill you when you're making it. It can kill you when you're taking it.
Some call it the new crack cocaine.
It changes your personality. It changes your looks. It changes who you are.
Can the new high of the heartland be stopped? Plus, echoes of the Nazi horror. Children classified as handicapped and murdered in the name of medicine. Their story on Impact. Sunday, 9 Eastern on CNN.
For news anytime, turn to CNN. And now, CNN has more news in the mornings with frequent weather updates, more sports and business reports. Wake up to Early Edition, weekdays, 7 Eastern on CNN.
The latest album from the R&B group Boyz II Men, Evolution, debuted in the number one spot on the U.S. album chart with sales of more than 200,000 copies. Let's turn now to the top 10 singles of the week as compiled by Billboard magazine.
Songs have to be listed in the top 10 to be appreciated. In fact, the songs created by one charity group are designed to appeal to an audience of just one. Cynthia Tornquist reports on A Song of Love.
6-year-old Christina Rodriguez of Brooklyn tested positive for the HIV virus 2.5 years ago. She doesn't understand, but she knows she is sick. When she's feeling blue, she listens to her favorite song, a tune written especially for her.
To see her face light up when that song is played is everything.
Put together all you dream about.
The song was written and recorded by the cast of the Broadway musical Titanic for a nonprofit group called Songs of Love, which commissions professionals to compose tunes for sick children. John Belzer created the charity as a tribute to his twin brother, a songwriter who committed suicide 13 years ago.
I was walking down the street and I was overcome with this incredible desire to start this organization whereby we provide children who are either chronically or terminally ill with their very own song.
It's so easy to write a song for a kid when you find out what their interests are, what their likes are. It's so great to be able to put a sister into a song or something. You find the song just writes itself.
More than 500 songs have been recorded for ailing children across the United States. Many of them have been financed on Belzer's own credit cards. But whatever the cost, Belzer says it's worth it to see the look on a child's face. After Christina's song was recorded, the Broadway performers invited the six-year-old and her mother to a performance of Titanic and later presented her with her new song.
Thank goodness for these people who did this, because this is something that'll last a lifetime for her.
It makes me feel happy. I never had a song about me.
Cynthia Tornquist, CNN Entertainment News, New York.
We just can't follow that, so that's it for now. But tomorrow, we will have some music of the country variety, a live visit from Naomi's daughter and Ashley's sister. Who else? Winona. We hope to see you then. In New York, I'm Lauren Sidney.
And in Hollywood, I'm Jim Moray. For everyone here at Showbiz Today, thank you for watching. We'll see you next time.
525,600 minutes. 525,000 moments so dear. 600 minutes. How do you measure, a year? In daylights, in sunsets, in midnights, in cars.